everyone, I am Rohit and welcome to my YouTube channel AI Era. So guys, in this video, we are going to explore one more exploratory data analysis tool called an autoplotter. But before moving deep into what is autoplotter and how it is used, I would like to tell you that I will create a video on pandas library and on numpy library. Also, my current new library that I am working is a data visualization library. So I am already created videos on pandas and numpy library. Believe me guys, if you want to work in a data science field or in future if you want to become a data scientist, then starting with this library is give you a very good confidence. So please access those library to clear more concept about data science. And do subscribe my YouTube channel, that is AI Era, and press and bell icon. So without doing any delay, we just move into our Jupyter notebook. So guys, here I am in my Jupyter notebook. So you can see already we are explorer data analysis techniques such as AutoWeave and pandas profiling. Such exploratory data analysis techniques will require only few lines of code to explore a full data. So autoplotter will give you also this flexibility to write only few lines of code, and it can give a better visualization or better intuition about this or any kind of data. So before moving towards autoplotter, we just take a brief idea about what is autoplotter. Basically, autoplotter is an open source Python library built on top of Dash, which enables the user to do exploratory data analysis using a graphical user interface. Basically, autoplotter is built on top of Dash. So we also required to install a Dash module as well as autoplotter module using a pip command in our system. Basically, Dash is a Python framework built mainly on top of Flask and plotly.js and used to create web apps. The autoplotter is just like a dashboard in which you can load any dataset and start exploratory data analysis. So to import an autoplotter module and dash module in our system, we have to open our command prompt. Here I can open my Anaconda PowerShell prompt. Enter pip install autoplotter and I have to press and enter. According to internet speed, it will give you results. You can see over here, it will show me requirement already satisfied because I am already installed this module in my system. The next, I have to install my dash module by using same command, that is pip install dash and press and enter. You can see over here, it will show the same command, that is requirement already satisfied because I am already installed dash module in my system. So we can minimize it and focus onto our Jupyter notebook. So guys, to working with any kind of data or to read any kind of data, we required library called pandas. So we import a pandas library by saying simply pandas sq, and we can simply import our autoplotter module in our system. So from autoplotter module, we have to import a run app. To execute this first cell, I have to press a shift enter. When this asteroid is get converted into number, then this my particular cell get executed. Okay, so it shows the number 1 and my cell is get successfully executed. The next, I have to set my working directory. So I have to import a OS module, and by simply typing os.change directory and in close parenthesis, I have to set or I have to give my working directory. So here I am, here my working directory is E drive and in pandas folder. To set or to execute this cell, I have to press and shift enter. Then to visualize data set, or first I have to import any kind of data set. So here I can use a housing data set that is in CSV format. CSV is nothing but a comma separated value dot CSV format. To import this data set, I have to simply write df is equal to query.read underscore CSV, and in close parenthesis I have to mention my data set with its extension. To execute this cell, I have to press and shift enter. Then for creating a data visualization, I have to pass my data frame from that run underscore app. After successfully executing this cell, it will give me a URL link, it shows over here, with some data preview. For better visualization, I can click on this URL and it will open in my next tab. So you can see over here, it will shows me a data preview. In data preview, it shows a data contained in my dataset with its feature. By scrolling down, you can see over here, it will contain total 1032 pages. The whole dataset nearly having 20,000 rows, and in 20,000 rows will summarize in 1032 pages. So next is I have to click on that data exploration. After clicking data exploration, it will shows me a three columns, that is data distribution, second is statistical analysis, and third is association. In data distribution, by default it will select a column, that is longitude. In select column, we can select any column, and according to our column it will shows a data distribution over here, and we can select theme on which we have to see our data. So here by default it will select a plotly dart. So I can show you, I can select another feature or another column, that I can select a median income, and here instead of plotly dart I have to select a simple white. You can see over here, it will show a data distribution very well. The next is statistical analysis. In statistical analysis, it will, in here, you can observe that a data frame shape, and it shows that it contains a 20,640 rows with 10 features. With its contents, each and every feature, mean value, median value, minimum value, maximum value. The next is association. In association, we can find out correlation between two features. So here I can select a total bedroom as my first feature, and I can select the second feature of my median house value. Then automatically it will give me correlation between these two features is 0.049. The next is click on that plot. After clicking on that plot, here we have to select a few parameters, such as choose plot type. Here instead of scatter I will select a histogram, and I will keep theme as a plotly dart, and on x-axis I have to select a population. Then you can observe over here, it will give me a histogram for more visualization, or for more clarification I can change this x-axis to total rooms. So it will create a histogram of total rooms. Then I can create such a bar plot of my total rooms. So you can see over here, it will show a bar plot of my total rooms. To For bar plot, I can select another feature such as housing median age and wait for a second to plot that bar plot automatically. Okay, it will show a very nice result of housing median age. The x-axis which contains housing median age, and my y-axis is shows over here. So this is enough for today's video. So this is a new technique to explore data analysis. So guys, the documentation about autoplotter is provided by Mr. Himanshu Sharma. So it's my request to go through this documentation to get more knowledge about that autoplotter and how it's work. The link is below in description. So this is enough for today's video. If you like this video, please like it, share with your friend, and do subscribe my YouTube channel. And don't forget to press the bell icon and never miss any update. Thank you one and all.